Hey, it's Eric here. Let's go ahead and talk about the pen tool in Scratch. Now, I admit, when I found out there was a pen tool in Scratch, I had no idea what that meant, and it took me a few minutes to understand how it works. But now that I understand how it works, I use it in almost every project. So that being said, let's go ahead and explain it this way. We have our project here to our left. We'll go ahead and run it, and we see that it's just a sprite sort of running around the screen, bouncing around everywhere. Now, say we want to create a trail behind this sprite. We would do that using the pen tool, which is essentially to say that I want to push my pen down and draw wherever that sprite was, okay? So we literally will do that. That's the first step. We say pen down. We see pen up, but we want pen down. So pen down, when green flag is clicked, push that pen down to the backdrop. Now, what color is that pen? Well, let's set the pen color. So that's this block right here. Set pen color to. So we'll go ahead and attach that. And this is one of the most intuitive like user interface blocks in Scratch, because we can go ahead, if we click in here, this enables us, and you can see the icon has switched here, the cursor has switched to a hand, and wherever that hand is over, we will take that color. So say we want this like blue here, it's a nice blue, so we just go ahead and click it, and it will then take on that color. So pretty cool. Now, let's say we want to distinguish the size of the pen. So we see down here, we see set pen size to 1. So let's go ahead, click, attach that. So set pen size to 1. Let's go ahead and make it 3, okay? So pen's going to be down, it's going to be blue, and it's going to be 3 wide. So let's go ahead and test it out. So there you go. Pretty cool, right? Very artistic. Very nice. So we'll go ahead and stop it. Now say we want to clear out what we just created here. This pen tool looks nice, but we want to get rid of it. This is the first block here that's clear. So we can go ahead and hit that. And we see it simply, it clears out the pen tool. You can see the pen tool is pretty straightforward to use. Now we didn't mention this block here, change pen color by 10. So you can easily use this in your sequence to start to change the color dynamically. Also we have the change pen size. So instead of just setting the pen size, you can have the pen size be changing dynamically in a sequence as well. Now let's talk about these two blocks here. Change pen shade by 10 and set pen shade. So essentially a shade is going to be the shade of a color. So you have a light blue and a dark blue. And what this will enable us to do if we use a, say, forever loop, is we can see that the shade of this blue can be changing. So we'll go to our pen tool and say, always be changing that shade by 10, right? So we'll go ahead and click this, and we'll see that the trail will go from a lighter blue to a darker blue to a lighter blue to a darker blue. So you see, it's changing the shade constantly by 10. So again, very cool, very artistic, nice to have in your arsenal when you're building out a project. So we'll go ahead and clear. And we'll talk about this last tool here, and that's the stamp tool. Now the stamp tool will create a duplicate, right, of your sprite. So if we have a stamp of this, we can go ahead, there you go, we'll click it, oh, we see a stamp. So we've created a stamp of the object right there. So you can also do this, if you do it in a loop, you can create multiple stamps of that object. So we'll go ahead, test that out, go back to our pen tool, and then we'll click, oh, so there you go. We get 10 different stamps of that object. Now, we might want to put a little bit of wait time in there so we can actually have something that looks decent. So we'll go ahead, we're going to wait a second and then stamp, wait a second and then stamp. So we'll go ahead and clear it out, and we'll see what it looks like. So there we go, wait a second, stamp, wait a second, stamp. So that being said, these tools really take on a life of their own when you put them in loops. So feel free to experiment and have fun.